What's good? Y'all know who it is. Y'all know what it is. Your boy Matthew Shack, live here in Los Angeles. Welcome to Matthew Shack Unfiltered. Last night, NBA draft was very interesting, to say the least. Had my projected picks. A lot of them went lower than I thought, and a lot of them went higher than I thought. And there was some movement in regards to the trade landscape. First pick of the draft was Paolo Banchero out of Duke. And the Orlando Magic once again gets a number one draft pick, man. They got a history of number one draft picks and have never won a championship, man. You got to remember their crown jewel and then their number one draft pick that they ever drafted was Shaquille O'Neal. Didn't get nothing out of it. Got an NBA Finals appearance. Got smashed on by Hakeem Olajuwon and the Houston Rockets with a young Shaq. But they've squandered so many first-round picks. Dwight Howard, you know, that's another guy squandered, you know. So we'll see what happens with Paolo, man. Solid kid out of Duke, good program, you know. I think he's going to be a decent player. Of course, a lot of these players are, you know, they're a little light in the draws. They're going to have to hit the weight room. They're going to have to live in the weight room, get their NBA bodies on point eventually. But I think that was a good pick. Second pick was Chet Holmgren for OKC. And OKC made some moves, man. OKC is got their youth movement popping. I was very surprised, man, that they made that move, man. And Jabari Smith went third, who I thought was going to go first for the Houston Rockets. Another team that is doing kind of a youth movement right now. If they can move John Wall and do a couple of things like that, then it's possible. With the 13th pick, man, the New York Knicks made a major move by acquiring the 13th pick and trading Kemba Walker to the Detroit Pistons. So they got the 13th pick for some other considerations. And picked up Kemba Walker over at the Pistons. And the Pistons, they looking like they back in, you know, they back in contention on paper. A lot of interesting things going on, man. As far as the things that everyone claimed and swore their life was going to happen, Russell Westbrook is still a Los Angeles Laker, man. Nobody wants that big-ass, bloated-ass contract, you know. There was a report that the Lakers tried to trade Russell Westbrook to the Pacers for very minimal compensation, and the Pacers laughed them out of the contract negotiations, man. Just laughed them out the building. Like, are you serious, man? I'm not paying this guy $47 million. You taking all the assets, man? Nah, man. You got to give it up. You know, if they really wanted to get rid of Russ, it would have took them trading Russ and a first-round, you know, a first-round draft pick in the future. A future first-round draft pick. But the Lakers don't have no first-round draft picks, you know? To really afford to give them up, because they gave everything up to get Anthony Davis, you know. So that's what it is, man. You know, you can't rob Peter to pay Paul in this situation. As far as the world champion Golden State Warriors, man, they're just doing what they're doing, man, getting all what they need to get through the draft, and they are the poster child of how to build a franchise, man, through the draft. They drafted everybody that they got, man. Hardly outside of Andrew Wiggins. You got three first ballot Hall of Famers that they drafted, with Steph Clay and Draymond. Then Jordan Poole, they drafted him. So it's just like, you can get what you got to get through the draft. You can definitely do that if you have the scouting department. You have the ability to evaluate talent. You can make it happen. So we're going to see what happens, man, with upcoming season. It was cool last night. It was cool seeing these young cats and their families become instant millionaires, dog. I was telling my wife, man, we were watching it. I was like, look, babe, all these kids have been set up for success, okay? Parents working their asses off. Mothers working two or three jobs. You know what I'm saying? Fathers there, you know, trying to hone the talent and hone the skill and sacrifice as a family. And within a couple of minutes, man, all those guys in the top 10 and beyond, especially those top 10, especially those top 3. Their family don't have to do nothing again, man. Mama can quit the job tomorrow, okay? Might have quit today. And I was like, that's how you set your kids up for success, man. If you can't be successful, set your kids up for success, man. Later on down the line, when it pops off of them, they're going to take care of you. If you the type of parent that deserves that. And it seemed like all those kids was very happy with their families, super supportive. And it's just like with the NFL draft, man. I love seeing that, dog. It shows that there's still hope out there. It shows that there's still opportunity and people getting what they deserve if they're willing to put themselves out there. So we're going to see how it all pans out, man. Salute to all those young cats, man. Every one of them, every player that fulfilled their dream of being drafted into the NBA. And we're going to see what you guys do. All right, man. Love all y'all out there, man. Matt Shackle Filter.